Welcome back to the channel. The video today is going to show you how to combine the video that you shot with your cinema camera with the data that's been logged from your gyro in your action camera using Gyroflow. Now, if this is the first video of mine that you've watched, go back and see the last video I did, which has links to the software that you're going to need to be able to do this. I'll put a link down in the description below. With that said, let's get on and into the video. On my desktop, I've got a couple of folders. The first one has got the content from the two cameras, and the second one has got Gyroflow, FFmpeg, and the camera presets. We're going to open up Gyroflow and click on the fancy camera stabilizer. And I'll just rearrange everything so that it all fits onto the screen. I've got Gyroflow stabilizer open and the terminal window, which shows me what's happening in the background. The first step is to open up the camera preset. For each camera and lens combination, you need a specific camera preset. Good news is there's a whole bunch that have already been done and you can create them yourself. The next step is to open the video file. This is the video that you shot with the cinema camera. I'm shooting in 4K ProRes and the file format that's created is an MOV file. That means when you use the open dialog box, you've got to change it to all file types so that you can see that MOV file. You then need to select the gyro file. The gyro file is the video that came from your action camera. And again, you're going to need to change it to all file types so that you can see that video file. The gyro data for this video is being recorded with a GoPro Hero 7. So in the dropdown, I'm switching it from the default to Hero 7. And then I hit the plot and analyze gyro data just to make sure that the data's loaded and everything's working. I've moved now to the sync tab. And I'll press the auto sync button and wait for it to sync the video and the gyro files together. I've sped this up so that you don't have to wait through the video. It's finished doing what it needs to do and you can see it's synced up quite well. I'm now going to apply those sync settings. The field of view slider allows you to zoom in and out on your footage and see how much gyro flow has stabilized the clip. As you're watching the clip, you can see the black frame around the outside of the clip, which is how much is being cropped in. Under the Stabilize tab, there's five different options for smoothing your video. Most of these aren't applicable if you're using a cinema camera. In fact, the only one that seems to work for me is the default one, that 3D smoothing. I really hope that you're enjoying my videos just as much as I enjoy making them. If so, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel because I've got plenty more hints, tips and tricks that I'd love to share with you. We've made it to the output tab. The first thing you need to do is set the resolution of your output file. I'm setting this as standard definition just because it's a demo. If you have the adaptive zoom checkbox checked, it will automatically remove that shaky black margin around the outside of your video and crop everything in nicely, and it'll move in and out as it needs to on the clip. The final thing that I do before hitting export is to turn off the display during render. It just speeds up the whole process. You hit the export button, give your stabilized clip a name, and away it goes. Now, the time it takes to render the file is going to depend on the output resolution that you've selected, the length of the clip, and the power of your machine. I've sped it up during this video just so that we don't have to wait to see the output. Once it's finished, you'll see the notification in the terminal window and you can close everything down. Now everything's finished. You can open up your project media folder and see the stabilized clip that we've just created. In my next video, I'll show you how to use the camera calibrator and create your own camera presets.